Sitting by you and tell that person that tonight is your night. Oh, I say, look unto that one and say that tonight is your night. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Do you have your Bible? Man of God, God bless you. And your wife, shout hallelujah. And may the Lord bless all the men of God. Shout amen. The Lord bless the First Lady, Pastor Vivian. Shout glory be to God. May the Lord bless you. Say to yourself that indeed, I am blessed. Say, God bless me. Shout hallelujah. Those who are watching all over the world, may the Lord bless you. May your life never be the same. May your life never be the same. Everybody shout hallelujah. Do you have your Bible? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. I Thank God, yesterday was great. Am I right? The Lord did amazing things. Shout amen. Do you still have your water? Or you used it yesterday? Shout hallelujah. Were you able to get home before? Are you sure? Shout glory be to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to me. Expect your miracle. I say, expect your what? Your miracle. Shout amen. Something wonderful will happen. Shout amen. The Lord wants to take us onto another dimension tonight. And be rest assured that indeed you will receive the touch from heaven before you leave this place. 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter what? Chapter 6. Yesterday was 2 Kings what? 5. And today, 6. And who knows, maybe tomorrow we'll go to 7. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Hila baziki brosinta. Labaka siki tori brosikita apaka. Father, we bless you, Lord. We bind every powers of the enemy. Forever, O Lord, that word is settled in heaven. Lord, we give you all the praise, we give you all the honor, Father. May your name be praised. Liba hakasikita harabashiki. Hatarababa. Liba hakasikita. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Kings chapter what? Chapter 6 and verse number 1 coming. I'm reading from the NIV. Pastor Rick is here. Do you have the NIV Bible? Pastor Rick? Are you sure? Okay, let me proceed. If I need you, you will come in. Shout amen. The company of the prophets, can you see it? According to the NIV. Shout amen. The company of the what? Of the prophets. Not prophets. Plural. Am I right? Said to Elisha, the company of the prophets said to what? Elisha. Look, the place where we meet with you is too small for us. The place where we what meet with you is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan. Yesterday we had Jordan, am I right? And today to Jordan. Let us go to Jordan. Not we will go. We the prophets. But Papa, let us go to Jordan, where each of us can get a what? A pool. And let us build a place there for us to what? To meet. That's your word. Bless your word. In Jesus' name. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Listen to me. Not tomorrow, but I'm talking about now. I'm talking about what? Now. Why let us go to Jordan and cut a what? King James said, beam, and to build another place. Church, and now, is too small. The place you are now, then somebody said, what are you talking about? I am talking about your spiritual environment and physical environment. Number one, the sons of the prophets, they noticed, am I right? And they said that where we are is too small. Now we can't even put our chairs. We don't have a place to put our Bibles. It's too small. Master, we have to live here. We have to enlarge our tent. The word of the Lord says that, number one, open your mouth wide, and the Lord shall what? And he said that you must stretch your what? Your curtains. Enlarge your what? Your tent. Your own curtains. It's not God that will come from heaven and enlarge your tent for you. Number one, you just have to stretch your curtains wide and just leave it. The one who has to come and fulfill it will come. And his name is Master Jesus. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. How come those people, the sons of the prophet, didn't say that, God Almighty, why don't you come and what? Enlarge our tent for us. But they realized, they noticed, they found out that the place was too small for them. That was the time they consulted their prophet, their leader, and said that, can you go with us? And the prophet said, yes, I will go with you. And listen to me. The time they started moving in the realms of the spirit, Satan didn't like that idea. Anytime somebody will try to do something or to enlarge your own tent and to move from where you are to another place, I want you to know that Satan, Lucifer, will not be what? Happy about that decision. The enemy wanted them to stay in that same place. Everybody shout hallelujah. Oh Lord, I know that indeed I am blessed with this my apartment. Thank you, Jesus. I don't need anything. This is my townhouse. Oh, Father, I am blessed. I've been in America for 32 years. And I look at my two bedrooms, my apartment. You have been paying 1,200 or 1,500 for 32 years. The Lord is telling you tonight that enough is enough. Amen. It is time for you to move from that small place and to go to your Jordan and bring another beam and to enlarge your tent. And how can you do that? Because the enemy is happy about your situation, your present condition. Satan is happy. The enemy wants you to stay where you are, but the Lord wants you to move forward. But the moment you try to move forward, the enemy will fight you. But let me tell you this, it is better for me to move forward, for the enemy to fight me, and for me to conquer the enemy, shout hallelujah, than for me to stay my what? My comfort zone. My that small place. After this fasting and prayers, some of you, the Lord will change your physical situation. Oh, I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. The Lord will change it. Whether you like it or not, your God will come from above and change it. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I prophesying to somebody? Am I speaking to somebody? You will try to put some things together. Oh, I have to move from this place. That one bedroom and to move to what? To two bedrooms. Am I right? And you start, you know, putting some things to, hey, lo and behold, something from nowhere will come in and swerve everything. It means that Satan doesn't want you to move from that your small place to your two bedrooms. It is time for me to move from my two bedrooms and to have my own townhouse. Shout hallelujah. And you will start putting something together. You lo and behold, something will come from what? And serve everything. Oh God, What is really going on? The enemy doesn't want you to move from that two bedrooms to your three bedrooms. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that, man of God? As I'm speaking right now, as a servant of God, you know your situation. You know where you are right now, your condition. You want to come out, but you can't. You have been praying for strength. Am I right? But you can't. Tonight, the Lord wants me to announce to you that your maker, the one who created you, is about to fight on your behalf tonight. And you are going to come out. I say, you are going to what? Come out from that your small place. Shout hallelujah. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? That your small place can be the life of what? A stagnancy that you have been for 10 years. Lord, when are you going to visit me? Father, when are you going to? Oh, 2017. Oh, I will see greater things. It can be your small place. Lord, I know that 2017, oh, I will have my wife. And 2017 will pass to 18, 19. You won't see anything. It can be that your what? Small place. They themselves noticed everything. And they said that, no, we cannot stay here. We don't like this kind of what? Environment. Our situation, no. Let's go to Papa. Prophet Elisha, you know that where we are is too small for us. Let us go to Jordan and cut beams and build a powerful church. Big place over there so that we will feel good. Because this place is too small. Shout hallelujah. He said, let's go. And they went. And they started cutting the wood, the beams. Everybody shout hallelujah. Church. Tonight, you and I will pray as never before. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? Do you know that one of the prophets, it was a prophetic school, a Bible school, and one of the prophets said to himself, though I don't have any ass head, am I right, that I can use to cut the beams, but I will go to my friend and borrow. I will go and ask my friend. And they started, and Satan was sitting somewhere and said that, you, these guys, I will show you where power lies. You want to enlarge your tent? You want to move from that to your situation? It won't work. I will fight you. And Satan started something. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, we serve a mighty God. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, we serve a mighty God. Everybody shout hallelujah. Pastor, read verse 3 and let's see something.
Then one of them said, would you please come with your servants?
Let me tell you this. And one of them said, won't you please come with what? With your servants? Shout hallelujah. He said, yes. It means that, listen to me, they consulted their leader. They needed spiritual backing. Leader, can you go with us? Shout hallelujah. And he said what?
I will.
And he said, I will.
Elisha replied.
Elisha replied.
And he went
with him. Uh-huh.
He went to Jordan.
Listen to me. They went to Jordan.
And began to cut down
what? Trees. Uh-huh. Listen to me. Listen. One of them was cutting down a... Listen to me. Church, put this thing in your mind. One of them was cutting down... No, no. Look on Jesus and say, eh. Shout hallelujah. Again, eh. Again, eh. Again, a tree. Shout hallelujah. Shout amen. Eric, you read again, okay? Shout hallelujah. Listen to me. Let me tell you something. You know, in the realms of the spirit, those who have occultic eyes, demonic people, they can speak to trees. You don't know? They can speak to trees. Some demons, they have already possessed some kind of what? Trees. I'm telling you. They started cutting, but one guy started cutting eh. And that eh. The tree said to the guy, there is no way you can cut me. You cannot touch me. I am going to show you where power lies. Shout hallelujah. Tonight, every tree in your life, you are going to speak to that particular what? Tree. And it will come down. Oh, I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. I didn't hear amen. Every tree in your life, get ready and you will cut it down. Every tree in your life, get ready, you will cut it down. It means that the things that the enemy has released in your life that has been fighting you for all these years, today with your prayer will become like a sharp knife, a sharp sword, and you will cut that tree. Oh, I didn't hear amen. May you cut that tree. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, every tree in my life, that kind of tree, I said that kind of tree will come down. May you make a joyful noise unto them. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to someone? Am I speaking to someone? Shout glory be to God. Ah, listen. They started cutting what? Trees. Am I right? But that that demonic tree said to that prophet, there is no way your ass can touch me. I will show you where power lies. And when the girl started cutting, what happened? As one of them was cutting down
the iron axe head
fell into, listen to me. The iron axe what? Head fell into the water. So what is the meaning of that? Shout hallelujah. Some of you don't know. That iron as what? Head. Have you seen it before? Some of you don't know. You will put some wood, am I right? Firewood.
You put one leg here and you will bend down. You will lift it up. Shout hallelujah. Just one touch, it will divide into three. Shout hallelujah. And you take it to kitchen. Shout hallelujah. And that native gas cooker, 1, 2, 3. Am I right? You will put it and put some small fire and you will bend down. Come and see. Mama, bring the food. Some of you, you are confused. What are you talking about? Go over there and you will see. Howard knows what I'm talking about. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to someone? If I'm speaking to somebody, shout hallelujah. When you put the intentions, it will, a white one, it will turn into what? Black one. Shout hallelujah. That is the power. Rare charcoal. Mukasi. Everybody shout hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? So the time the girl was about to what? Cut the what? That tree. The ass head, that iron one, fell into the water. What is the meaning of that? The tree said to that guy, do not touch me. Do you want to cut me? And to go and expand your church, your house, don't touch me. That is why the iron has head fell into the what? The water. And the guy started weeping. The guy started crying. Church, I am here to prove to you that it was an attack. It was a demonic attack. Because they started cutting. But why that? Shout amen. Church, let me tell you this. When your iron ass head fall, you have to consult your prophet. When your iron ass head fall into the water or into the pit, you have to consult your. It means that you have to seek for spiritual direction. The guy said, let me go to my prophet. And God so good. The prophet of God was what? With them. He said, the prophet, look at what happened. And the guy cried and he said what?
Oh no.
Oh no.
My Lord.
He cried out.
It was borrowed.
It was borrowed. I took it from somebody. So when I go home right now, what am I going to tell that person? Everybody shout hallelujah. Church, we have Mankala Baba. We are in a certain level right now. Listen to me. And this kind of level that you and I, we are in right now, if it would take you to borrow something from what? Someone, and to expand God's work, you have to do. Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? Then somebody will say that, what is the meaning of that? How come Satan didn't attack some of the prophet, but the one who borrowed from somebody that the enemy attacked? So when I go home now, what am I going to tell that, my friend? Papa, do something. I borrowed. And he started weeping. The prophet of God said, come here. Come and show me where that iron has what? Fell. Come and show me. Shout hallelujah. Church, look at this. How come a whole prophet of God asked that prophet, small prophet, and said that, come and show me. How come the prophet didn't say that? Bring something. Let me throw it into the what? The water, and something will happen. But he said, come, show me where that thing fell. Show me. I want to know. And the guy said, this place. Do you know the meaning? Then someone said, what is the meaning of that? You need something from the Lord, but you are searching at the wrong place. You need something from God, but you are moving on the wrong direction. Instead of you to consult God and to know where the things that you need is, you are just moving on the wrong direction. Come and show me. And the guy said, this place. Prophet Elisha could have said to the guy that, hey, I don't need your help, nothing, stay somewhere. Hey, you iron ass head, come out. But the prophet didn't do that. He said, come and show me. The things that you have been going through, the things that have been fighting you for all these years, do you know where that thing is? Can you show me? Prophet, I don't know. I don't know what I've been going to. I don't know. Anytime. Church, tonight you have to identify that thing. Amen. You have to know. He said, this place. He said, where? He said, this place. Shout hallelujah. So at times, a prophet can ask you, where did that thing word fell? You have to show the prophet. You have to tell the man of God that this place, everybody shout hallelujah. Oh, let's go and hire divers. 1 hour, we have to pay them $345. Divers. Some 1 hour is $1,000. Divers. The professional one, 1 hour over $2,000. Let's go and hire divers. And to put their, what did they call it? You know, the masks and, you know, their feet, everything. And come and bring that. Divers. The prophet said, we don't need divers. The owner of the sea. The owner of the universe. The one who created you. He is a powerful diver. And today, you will know that indeed God is with me. Shout hallelujah. Oh, Papa. One of them took his shirt off, everything. He was about to dive. Papa said, no, do not try. There is no way you will find it. Because this one is a demonic attack. The guy caught so many what beams. But how come that particular what beam? Satan attacked that guy. Why? Am I speaking to somebody? Am I talking to someone? You want to move from where you are to another place. But anytime you try, Satan will tell you, hey, my hand is on you. I am going to attack your iron ass what? Head. There is no way, nothing you can move. And something, oh, I want to move from. And guess what? At the end of the day, when you become frustrated, you know, I want to move from Maryland to Mexico. Shout hallelujah. Some hasty kind of decision. You pack all your things. I'm going to Montana. The God Almighty has revealed to you that you have to go to Montana. When you live here out of what frustration to Mexico, that same frustration will bring you back. You have to stand and face Satan. And say that starting from today, I have just 2 minutes. Starting from today, you can never attack my iron ass head again. I am not going to move from Maryland. I will stay here and face you and conquer you, and for you to know that I serve a living God. Church, you have to conquer those demons in Maryland before you move to New York. Because if not, when you move from here to New York, the same demon will follow you there. And the devil will give you some powerful reason. You know, here the rent is too high. Just one apartment, you know, apartment, 1500, am I right? 1500, like there in the hotel, like 1700. You know, here is too, when you go to Missouri, it's half, 600. You can go to Missouri. The nurses in Maryland, when you receive 14, Missouri is 8. And over there, there is no competition. You have to stay where there is what? So that you become somebody. Because when you go to Missouri and when you become Oga over there, when you come to Maryland, you will not be Oga. Then you will see Ogas. Everybody, am I speaking to you? And why are you shaking your head like that? That twin lady, you are shaking your head. Shout hallelujah. It means that the enemy has already held your iron as what? Head. The enemy doesn't want you to move. The devil wants to confuse you. Whereby you'll be frustrated and say, let me go home. There is no, I don't want to cut the beams again. I have to go home. How come? I borrowed the whole thing from my friend and I wanted to do something. And God, you have to sit down for me to go to. Father, are you there? Because of your work. That is why I went to my friend and borrowed that what? Iron ass head. And now you allow Satan. Oh God, I am tired and fed up. I don't know what I've been going to do. Cannot do the work of God and at the same time go through some. Listen to me. God can allow something to what? To happen in your life for his own glory. Shout hallelujah. The Lord wanted to prove to the prophet that indeed God was with who? Elisha. Elisha said that, come and show me. The guy said that this, Eric, read, please. 1 minute. Verse 6. The man of God asked, where did they fall? When he showed him, listen to me. When he showed what? Him. Elisha cut what? Listen to me. I need one stick. Look at this.
This is River Jordan. Another small one. Small one, please. Shout hallelujah.
Shout glory be to God.
Let's take it like this. This is River Jordan, okay? River what? Jordan. And that iron what?
As head.
Am I right? Was it in what? This what? But under. Am I right? Because when you put a paper into the water, there is no way the paper will work, same. But when heavy stone, something, whether you like it or not, am I right? Shout hallelujah. Am I right? I think we all know the reason why. Shout amen. Divers have to come and dive and bring it out. But the prophet said that, no. God wants to prove everybody wrong. I am going to put a light, am I right? Something, stick, praise the Lord, into the what? The water. Shout hallelujah. The stick that the man of God threw into the water, what happened? The stick didn't go down. Shout hallelujah. It was on top. And lo and behold, that heavy metal. Heavy metal started, 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 started
coming.
Started
coming.
Tonight I can see something.
Amen.
Oh, I can hear you.
I can see something happening right now in your life. That your heavy metal, that your iron ass head is swimming itself. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. But look at this. So when the man of God threw that stick into the water, all the sons of the prophet and plus Papa Elisha, all of them, shout hallelujah. They said, let's see what will happen. All of them. They paid who? Attention. And they were looking. They saw something like, some kind of movement, some kind of movement, some kind of movement. Lo and behold. By the time they realized, here comes the iron as head on top. So the question right now is, who brought it up? Who brought it up? Everybody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The stick that the prophet threw into the water represents the word of God. It represents the what? The word of God. The time Moses delivered the children of Israel, they reached somewhere and they needed water. All of them became thirsty. And Moses said, oh, here comes a powerful water. All of them started. And the water was well bitter. And they named the place what? Marah, which means bitter. Shout hallelujah. Maybe today your place is what? Called Marah. But I'm here to tell you that that bitter situation is going to turn into sweetness. Shout glory be to God. Am I speaking to somebody? And Moses said, they went to Moses and all of them started complaining. Am I right? They said, oh, the water is bitter. The water is bitter. The water is killing us. And what Moses said, hey, I need another stick. Give me a stick. Shout hallelujah. And Moses threw that same stick into the what? The water. And he spoke. And he said that you can try it again. Hey, it tastes like sugar. Hey, it tastes like honey. It was bad direction. Tonight, every iron ass head that belongeth to you, that the enemy, demons in your family, they have buried that thing under the water. But the spoken word of Yeshua, that iron head will come out. Oh, I didn't hear amen. May you be on your feet and make a joyful noise. May you be on your feet and make a joyful noise. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, that iron head will come out. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look at someone and say, that iron head will come out. Everybody shout glory be to God. How about God bless you? Am I speaking to somebody? Look unto somebody and say, this is your time. Look at someone and say, this is your time. Church, the question right now is, how come Satan attacked that young prophet? It was because of air. Shout hallelujah. And where is your air? Shout glory be to God. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I speaking to somebody? And look at this. The enemy number two wanted to put that guy into what? Trouble. Am I right? Disgrace. Because you took a whole thing from me. How can you come and tell me that you can't find it? Church, the guy said, oh, Papa, what do you want me to do? Any kind of shame, disgrace that the enemy wants to put you in, your God will turn your disgrace, your shame into glory. Shout hallelujah. You shall not be put to shame. Instead of garment of mourning, you shall receive a garment of praise. Instead of you to weep, you will laugh. Instead of you to die, you will live. Instead of you to complain, you will give testimony to God. Instead of you to fall, you will stand. Instead of you to cry, you will shout hallelujah. Instead of you to fold your hands and stand somewhere, you will dance before the congregation of the Lord. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Where is your iron head? Where is your iron ass head? Where is it? Everybody shout hallelujah. Where is it? Everybody shout amen. Where is it? The water covered the what? The iron head. Am I right? Shabu Karabasianta. I am here to warn you today, as a prophet of God, do not use physical what? Strength and to fight against spiritual things. They will finish you. Because we are not resting against flesh and blood, but and our weapon are not carnal, but mighty, pulling down. I will show them what power lies. I will insult them. I will do this. I will show them what power. Physical strength. They will slap you at night. Well, you can't even talk again. You will hear just one dirty slap. Everybody shout hallelujah. We are going today to meet them with spiritual strength. And our spiritual strength is our prayers. We are going to speak. We are going to speak. Do you know the reason why God wants me to share this message with somebody? Because tonight I am speaking to somebody. Tonight the Lord wants to bring back somebody's destiny. Oh, I didn't hear amen. The Lord wants to bring back somebody's destiny. I don't know if I'm talking to you. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. God wants to bring back somebody's destiny. You need a miracle. And when he threw it into the water, the iron head what started coming out. And he said to the young prophet, he said, take it. Take it. The other verses said, I lift it up. And the guy did what? The guy did what?
Then the man reached out his hand.
And the man reached out his hand. And what?
And took it.
Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Am I speaking to somebody? When we go to heaven, I will ask for that boy or that man. I believe 100% that for you to reach your hand and what? To grab a hold. I don't know if the guy continued the work or went home. You have to answer yourself. The Bible says, so I don't want to be a false teacher. Shout hallelujah. I believe that if the Lord, is not a Sabbath guitar. I believe 100% that day the guy will say that, Papa, I am done. I want to go home because of the fear. Shout hallelujah. Or maybe the guy continue because the God has some kind of power. Shout hallelujah. You can rise up at times to do something and the enemy will try the possible means to break you. The enemy will kill your enthusiasm, the strength that God has given unto you. The enemy will kill it. You don't have to cry. The Lord is about to visit you today. Where is your iron head? Where is it? Under the water? Somewhere in your village? In America? Somewhere? Or they have already put it in somebody's grave? Today is your day. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. I say today is your day. Amen. Look at somebody and say today is your day. Can I tell you something before we pray? We all know that the iron head, whether you like it or not, it has to be heavy. It has to be what? Iron. Heavy. Shout hallelujah. Your situation right now is heavy. Your situation right now, your present condition right now, you can't even carry it. It's heavy.
your God is going to use, excuse me, forgive me with due respect, foolish and stupid direction. We have doctors here. We have professors here. Which I can say that some of the professors will tell you that, hey, with this one, according to article B, C, D, the gravity force, the strength of Archimedes, there is no way this one can work. We need divers with their spectacles. Am I right? Divers, we need even seven divers. One have to go to the south. One have to move to the east. The prophet said, we don't need divers. God is going to use a stick and to bring it out. The professors say that you must be crazy. There is no way it will work. He said that, professors, you must stand here and see what the Lord will do. He said that, bring me a stick. He threw it and the professors started laughing. They said that you must be crazy. Once they were saying you must be crazy, they saw something coming up. Shout hallelujah. The witches in your family tonight, as they can see, they are laughing right now. They say that, look at this prophet. What are you talking about? We have already buried the person's destiny in the graveyard. And you are saying that that thing will come out. You, Frank Jumbo, you don't know what you are talking about. And all of them, they have already gathered. But the time you open your mouth, they will see the coffin in that graveyard. Huh? They will see under the tree, under the water. They will hear some kind of noise. Because your God is going to visit you with supernatural strength. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. I am here to announce to you your deliverance today. The eye have not seen and the ears have not heard, but your God will cause it to come to pass. Your ears, they have not heard, and the eye have not seen. Your God will cause a miracle. I command your iron head, 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 in your family house, in your family house, from your children, the iron heads in this ministry, the iron head that belong to restoration, the iron heads that belong to your father, the iron head that belong to you, the iron head that belong to me, the iron head that belong to your brother, the iron head that belong to your sister, the iron head that belong to Frank Jomo, the iron head that belong to Frank Jomo, the iron head that belong to Frank Jomo. Whether the witches like it or not, I will receive my iron head. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. This 2017, what is today's date? Today's date is what? 14. Are you sure? Thus saith the Lord from heaven, this 14th day of February 2017, Frank Jomo will receive his iron head. You shall receive your iron head. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Am I prophesying to somebody? Am I prophesying to somebody? If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Shibrataya Zantaya. The last one. You will never depart from this place with empty handed. Because that iron head, you borrowed it from somebody. You have to go and give it to that person. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Maybe as I'm talking right now, somebody is here. You are afraid because you have to give somebody something. Maybe you owe somebody, the person needs the money. Maybe you have to give something to someone whereby you will gain your respect. You have already reached to that situation. You don't know what to do. You will never leave here empty. Tomorrow morning, there shall be a phone call and somebody will pay your debts. I said, by tomorrow morning, there shall be a phone call
and somebody will cancel your debt. Somebody will pay your debt. Somebody will deliver you from the shame. They have ridiculed you for far too long, but it is time for you to sing hallelujah. Shout amen. Shout hallelujah. Can I preach more? Do you know the reason why that young guy cried? A whole prophet. He said, I borrowed. When I go, Papa, what do you want me to tell that guy? I borrowed. I don't want anybody to insult me. My friend will say that I must go and buy a whole thing back. And we said, you take it from me, please. I warn you. I told you that I wanted to go to farm. And you said that, you will come soon. I told you that, please, you have to keep it, please. That is my only iron head that I have. Please. And now you are telling me that, Papa, I can't go. I can't. And tell that guy that I can't find. Papa, do something. He said, come and show me. Everybody shout hallelujah. You want God to prove something unto you. You need some kind of a solution, am I right? In your life right now, your present condition right now. You have been crying. But listen to me. You will never live here with empty hands. You are going back to the place that you borrowed the what? The ark. And give it back to the owner. Amen. That's saying the Lord of hosts. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Church, if you want to do something for the Lord, the enemy will attack you. Whether you like it or not. But do not give up. Amen. If you want to move from where you are to another level, they will attack you. Anytime you pray for advancement in your life, moving forward, for God to lift you up. Church, anytime you pray for promotion, do not forget about attacks. Shout hallelujah. The things that your God can use and to prove to you that indeed, that you have been what? Lifted up. Do you know what I mean? It means that when you begin to face some attacks, because if you are not going up, no one will attack you. The enemy will be happy with you. I am telling you, some friends, they will be happy. You will begin to cry and they will console. Oh, what is going on every day? But the day you will say that, hey, something wonderful, they will stop talking to you. When you call them, they will not pick the phone. Because they know that your promotion has worked. But I'm here to prove to you that according to the book of Psalm 50, promotion cometh from above. Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Am I prophesying to somebody? May you lift up your two hands and say, today is my day. Say, today is my day. Where is Dan Mawuku, Efrey's husband? Is Dan here? Give me the communion, please. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look unto your neighbor and say, neighbor, tonight, with the signs and the tokens, your iron head, your ass head will come out. Will come out from that water. Look at someone and say, you don't need divers. Ross, you don't need divers. Doctor, you don't need divers. Hey, let me tell you this. With this, your situation as a Christian, a child of God, you don't need a famine. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. You don't need a famine. In America here or in your country, you don't need a famine. Fitting spirits, you don't need them. There is no way they can solve that problem. They don't, no, the answer is in the hands of God. The solution is in the hands of God. No demon. Shout hallelujah. And I'm here to tell you this. What your God can do, juju can't do. Can juju powers do something in your life? What do you have to give credit to those, excuse me, fianga demons? What your God can do, no juju.
hallelujah. Am I speaking to somebody? Juju powers can never overcome the power of God. The power of God supersedes the demonic powers. I am tired and fed up. I've been praying. I don't know anything. Let me go and see Afama. Afama for what? Afama for what? Don't you know that it's an insult to God? What my God can do, Juju can't do. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Lift up your two hands. Be on your feet. Don't put it here for me. God bless you. Say, in the name of Jesus, say, Spirit of the living God, today is my day. Say, Holy Ghost fire, I am going to speak into the atmosphere. Church, who wants to receive promotion in his or her life? You want promotion. You want to see promotion. Are you ready? Do you want to receive promotion? Do you need promotion in your life? Promotion in your business? Promotion in the your own life? About your children? Do you need promotion? Get ready. You are going to get one. Everybody shout hallelujah. Look unto somebody and say, it is time for you to move from that your comfort zone. Shout hallelujah. I challenge some of you here that according to the word of God, and as surely as my God liveth, by the end of 2017, some of you will move from 1 to 2 bedrooms, 2 to 3 bedrooms, 3 to your own house, in the mighty name of Jesus. And according to the word of God, so shall it be. You will ask yourself and say that, how can this be? There shall be a performance. There was a time I declared, you know, long time, I think about 2 years ago, declared some fasting and prayers, some wonderful, you know, members in this place. Lo and behold, receive a phone call. Say, how are you? Are you this and this and this? Say, me. He said, we want you to know that your debt has been what? Cancelled. He said, which kind of debt? He said, I don't know. They are here, but I don't want to ask. I don't want you to know they came and the whole thing. They are here looking at me right now. I think it was $98,000 or $78,000 was 98. And the man was about to say that, this one, the wife said, hey, keep your mouth shut. The man said that it has been canceled when we finish the fasting and prayers. Your God is going to cancel some of your debts. Everybody shout hallelujah. There is somebody in this place came to my office, which I won't mention any name. I don't do that. I don't. Shout hallelujah. Instead of him, you know, to pay his rent or something, you know what I'm talking about. And default, I think for three months or 2 months, you know, our sheriff, am I right? Came court order to evict him. Shout hallelujah. Officers. Knocking. He said, please, can you sit down? The guy told the officers, can you sit down? You cannot evict me. Wow. No, you cannot. There is no way you can. No. Officers, I want you to know, you cannot. Officers. They said that, okay. This and this and that. Okay, we want to give you this. Take your time and pack your things. When you are ready, go and drop the key to them, okay? We are not going to do anything. We just want to leave. Wow. And they saluted him. He said, no, officers, you cannot. A court order. Shout hallelujah. Your iron as head shall be what? Shall be what? Shall be what? Shall be lifted out. It will come out. Look at someone and say, you don't need divers. You need only the hand of God. That's it. Everybody shout hallelujah. Shout glory be to God. Your God doesn't want any divers to take the what? The glory. Because he will never share his glory with anybody. Your God is going to fight for himself. He's a young guy. Take it out. Take it. And he reached out his what? Hand. And he took it.